Great. Okay, so a while ago when I started my PhD, I attended a workshop in Leiden, and then at the lunch I sat opposite to Johan Dame, and after I introduced and told him I'm doing symmetric cryptanalysis, he told me, so you're also a bitfucker. And then I went back to my hotel room and I was like, well, I looked at myself, I looked at the work I was doing, and I actually didn't really see any bits. I only saw cycles on permutation. And at the start of my PhD, I did some work on this. I looked at the structure in permutations, and what I found out is that it's really well known how to find very small cycles, like one cycles. Fixed points. And it's also quite trivial to find really big cycles. Well, you can just, like, if you want to find a fixed point, you just take a step forward, look, have I been here before? Or is this where I come from? No, keep going till you find one. And big cycle, you just pick a point, just keep on walking and until you get back. And with high probability, that's a high cycle, large cycle. So then the question was, what about the smaller cycles? And I looked into it, and it was actually a bit harder. And we looked into it, how to find these things efficiently. We could shave off some constants, nothing very exciting. And then we asked some people, like, hey, do you know how this works? And we have this problem. And they said, yeah, it's a really nice problem, but why? What are the applications? And I had to think a long time. And most of the applications I could find is distinguishing between different families of permutations, like S and S squared, and improving certain types of slide attacks. But that's all I could find, so if anyone knows something, please contact me, talk to me, give me a beer, I'll need it. Thanks.